Wheelie bars. They are critical to launching your car if they're on the track. If you're launching your car and your wheelie bars are not on the track, or you don't have wheelie bars at all, this video is not for you. This is all about wheelie bars and how I've learned to adjust my wheelie bars to help keep my car going straight. This is after corner weights are taken. This is after any preload that I add to the left or rear side with me in the car. This is after shock adjustments, rebound, extension, and compression. But wheelie bars play a part into how your car tracks as long as those wheelie bars are on the track. If they're touching the track, they're helping steer your car. So let's talk about what the wheelie bars are doing and how they impact your car on those first 60 to 100 foot, however long you're carrying those front wheels. Now, my goal is not wheel stands. I don't like wheel stands. I'm losing time. I'm losing energy pulling the wheels up to the sky instead of pushing those wheels down the track. So, unfortunately, some cars require them. Not every car can you get all the lift out of the front end, but we do everything we can to keep those front wheels in tune with the track and on the track. It's hard to steer that race car with the front wheels in the air, and it's hard to win races when you really can't see how straight you're going. So wheelie bars are critical to keeping control of your car. So let's talk about those. Just want to show you my wheelie bars are level left to right, and on the launch it's holding the car straight down the track. Now, what if I were to lower the right rear wheelie bar? Had I lowered the right rear passenger side wheelie bar, that would have made my car go to the right. Let's talk about why that is. By lowering the right rear, I am actually unloading that right rear slick quicker than the left rear slick. Because as that wheelie bar pushes up on the top of the rear end, it's pulling that right rear slick off the track, giving more bite to the left rear slick. So when the left rear slick has more bite, it's going to drive the car harder to the right. Now, this will screw with your brain, but trust me, if the left rear is biting harder than the right rear, your car will steer to the right. The opposite holds true. Let's say we lower the driver's side left rear wheelie bar, and it's closer to the track. On the launch, that will drive the car to the left because the right rear will have more bite than the left rear, hence driving the car to the left. So whichever wheelie bar is closest to the track, that slick will not have as much bite as the other slick, and that will impact which way your car begins to drive. I can tell you on the 48 that when this car is scaled with me in it and everything race ready, we have about 50 pounds more on the left rear than we do with the right rear. And we do that by adjusting the right top four link bar to move weight. We also run our shocks even, and our anti-roll bar is neutraled. So this is with the 48 naturally aspirated, with the 406 running 6.0s to 598, 599, and launching around 3,500 RPMs with the trans brake, with 456 rear gears and a turbo 400 transmission. So you can see that we didn't really have to offset the wheelie bars to keep the car going straight. All we had to do was give it a little preload and add a little weight to the left rear of the car. A little bit of weight goes a long, long ways. Doesn't take a lot to make a quick change. Hopefully that made some sense. Wheelie bars can be fun. They can make you pull your hair out for sure. The main thing to remember is all this works as a combination. It's really critical that you start with the four link, then the shocks. I try to save the wheelie bars for the last thing I do. However, the wheelie bars can be very effective if you just need some minor changes. I don't adjust the anti-roll bar hardly ever. I try to keep the anti-roll bar neutral. I've seen guys add load with the roll bar, and if you don't have adjustable four links, you do what you got to do to move weight. We move weight around left and right by preload on the top rear right side four link bar. That's how we shift weight around. You can do a lot of fine tuning with wheelie bars though. And you know, if your car's driving to the left on the launch and the front wheels are not on the track, then you can lower the right rear wheelie bar a little bit, eighth inch, quarter inch. I'd go very small amounts. And it's going to correct the car back to the right if your car is going left. If your car is going right, you want to lower the left rear wheelie bar to help steer the car back the other way. This will screw with your brain. So stop, think, draw it out. Look at the video again. Look at the arrows again. They will help guide you when adjusting wheelie bars. And remember, if you're having to make big wheelie bar changes, you should stop and think about what else could be off. We do not have any rear steer in our 48 with this other motor. Now, with this new blown motor, we're starting all over. The amount of torque and horsepower is going to be very different. But you may have to make some other changes if you're having to make a lot of wheelie bar shifts. If you've got your wheelie bars more than a half inch or three quarters of an inch staggered, I would be trying to look and see, can I tune preload? Can I tune somewhere else? Does the car need a little rear steer? I don't want to get any one thing way out of balance. I'm trying to keep the balance of the car happy and not get something all out of whack. Anyways, enjoyed bringing this video to you. Look forward to doing more. Would love to do a series on double adjustable shocks, how the front and rear work together, how rebound and compression, how they work together, etc. Great information out there. It's not rocket science. It's physics. It just simple math and simple understanding of how things work together. Anyways, go fast, go straight. This is Kevin Wilson of Samson Performance. More videos to come soon, guys. Thanks.